Oh, we're on. Hi, this is InfoPuppet, and I really think you're gonna like this next tutorial. It's on fading images. It is a super awesome effect. You're gonna love my next Photoshop Elements tutorial. So Photoshop Elements 11 is open up, and this will work with PE 10 and PE 12. These are the images we're working on. We're going to get rid of these two girls right now, because we're going to start with these three. Okay, we're going to go to File, New, and Blank File. Then I'm just going to select OK. Alright, if you don't have the move tool, we're going to select the move tool. We're going to left click, hold, and drag the first girl onto the blank file. Now we're going to left click, hold, and drag the second girl onto the blank file. I'm going to readjust her a little and click on the green check mark. Now we're going to grab the last girl, left click, hold, and drag her onto the blank file. Okay, so here's what we've got right now. Let's look at the layers panel to see what's going on. We got the girl on the left on the top layer, the girl in the center in the center layer, and then the girl on the right is at the bottom layer, and then we have our background layer. Now I'm going to add a layer mask to the girl on the left. Okay, and I'm going to select the gradient tool. Now you need the black and white color selected. If you don't have them, click on this little button here, and if white's not on top, click on this button right here. Alright, so let's go down to the adjustments for the gradient tool. And we want to make sure linear gradient is selected and select edit. And we're going to select the first preset, which is foreground and background. And then click on OK. Alright, now we're just going to left click, hold and drag, and boom, look at that! What an awesome fade! So easy! Okay, now we're going to go to the girl in the center, click on her layer, add a layer mask again. And we're going to make sure we have the gradient tool. And again, I'm just going to left click, hold, and drag. And boom! Look at that! I love it! It is so easy and cool! Alright, I'm going to do some adjustments here. And now, if you didn't notice, the image on the left is a lot brighter than the other two, so we're going to fix that by going to Enhance, Adjust Lighting, and Brightness and Contrast. Okay, and now I'm sliding this up. You see how much better it fades in. I've got a really cool technique I'm going to show you, though. Don't go anywhere. And we're going to do Enhance, Adjust Lighting, and Brightness and Contrast again, and we're going to brighten her up so the image really works as one. Okay. Alright, now I'm just going to the history panel, and I'm going to go back to before we turned up the brightness levels. And I'm clicking on the middle girl and going to enhance, adjust color, and adjust hue and saturation. And now I'm washing out the images. It's not what we did before. Brightness and washing out the images are not the same. Okay, now I'm going to click on the third girl and again go to Enhance, Adjust Color, and Adjust Hue and Saturation. And we're going to go ahead and bring up the lightness to wash her out. Now, with those two girls on the right washed out, look how the girl on the left pops out of the image. Oh, I think I'm in love. But with the other two girls washed out, we can add like text over the top of them for a website or a flyer. You might want to dim a little bit more depending on the color of your text. Okay, so I just hit undo to go back to before we wash them out. And I'm going to go ahead and turn off the visibility of the girl on the right. Now, here comes the really cool technique. I'm telling you, this is unbelievable. So, what we're going to do is left click, hold, and drag this girl over. You can't see her too good right now. She's fading out. So we have to go to the layers panel. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna left click, hold, and drag her to the top so we can see what's going on. And I'm just gonna resize her. And now I'm gonna select the gradient tool. All right, here's the trick, you ready? I should probably charge for this, but it's free. Change linear gradient to radial gradient. You know what's gonna happen next? Well, first, of course, we have to click on the add layer mask, so we have our layer mask. Now we're gonna go ahead and left click, hold, and drag. And look at that! Photoshop Elements just faded the image in 360 degrees! Awesome! Now, I didn't exactly like that, so I hit undo, and I'm gonna do it one more time. I like this better. I'm gonna keep this one. Okay. So, let's go ahead and open up the other image, and we'll show you on this one. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna go ahead and I just left click and drag her, but you can't see her. Whenever that happens, you gotta drag the layer up to the top so you can see the layer, because we have a lot of layers now. I'm gonna add the layer mask and just gonna grab the gradient tool. And again, I'm gonna left click, hold, and drag, and boom, I love it. Now I'm gonna grab the move tool and we're just gonna slide her over here. And look at how nice the hair blends into the other image. Oh, I love this. I think, you know what? I think I'm gonna frame this one and hang it up in my living room. Okay, I just hit undo. And I wanna show you, this is a troubleshooting thing, but you can't dim or wash these out with opacity. And the reason why is because you're gonna get this line here where the image on the right ends. Okay? So that's why I taught you, when you want to wash them out, you're going to have to go to Enhance, Adjust Color, Adjust Hue Saturation, and then we use the Lightness Slider. Thank you so much! This is InfoPuppet! Please do me a favor and hit on the subscribe button! Thanks again! From InfoPuppet!